Are you actually scaling your footage the right way in Adobe Premiere, or I should say the way that actually preserves your pixel information with its best fidelity? Because it does make a difference in how you scale footage. Now, as a commercial cinematographer, I find myself often working with clients that want to have 1080 delivered files. I want standard HD files, but I'll still shoot in 4K because I want to have that extra ability to have that extra pixels, and more importantly, I want to have that ability to punch in. It's like having two cameras at once. Another thing to remember, this is not just for 1080 and 4K footage. A lot of us now have 8K cameras, so if you want to do a 4K edit, you can still film in 8K and still have that punching ability. You don't want to lose that information because it's so important to have. But how I scale this in Adobe Premiere makes a big, big difference in how well that pixel fidelity can be preserved. I want to show you a quick example of how it works. So now right here in Adobe Premiere, what I have is I have a standard 1080 timeline. This is very, very standard what I have. And what I have here, I'm just going to pull over three samples here. I have some 4K footage that I shot. So I'm going to pull it over first off. Now when I pull this in, it's going to ask me, do I want to keep the sequence settings? Yes, I do. I don't want to change to match it. And as you see here, I have these three clips here that are obviously too punched in and too big. Now, I'm only using three clips here, but honestly, lots of times you'll do shoots, you could come back with dozens and dozens of clips. You don't want to be in a situation where you have to come on each individual clip, come up here to scale, and then scale that down to 50%. That's just not practical when you got a lot of them. Now, a lot of you will have the instinct to select all your clips like this, right-click it, and you'll want to go to scale to frame size. It makes sense, right? So I'm gonna go scale to frame size, and boom, you will see right there that I have all these things scaled down to where they need to be. But here's the catch. Look up here at your scale. It is now telling me that this 4K footage in a 1080 timeline is 100%. I don't want 100% footage, because what if I have this footage right here that I want to punch in back to my full 4K size? Well, now if I want to scale it up, I have to put it at 200% to get to the full size. This obviously is now going at over 100%. I'm losing that pixel quality that I want to keep for that scaled down footage. So let me show you a better way on how to do this where you don't lose that pixel information. So I'm going to Command Z this just to go back to where I was. And instead of scale to frame size, I'm still going to select them all again. But this time I'm going to go to set to frame size. And what set to frame size does, exact same thing, but now you will see as I click on each of my clips, they're all set to 50%. So now what happens if, let's say I wanna come back to this image of my red Komodo and I wanna go to 100% and get that punch in, boom, it's 100%. I still have all that pixel information and all of my clips are set to 50%. It just gives me and preserves all that pixel information. Really, really makes a big difference. And I think it's one of those things that if you're shooting, you're really, really going to like and enjoy. And hopefully it helps you out there when you're editing. Anyway, guys, love to hear what you had to say about this. Leave me any notes and comments down below. And yeah, go out there, keep on shooting, and talk to you soon.